Welcome back once again, all of my low-carb friends, and for those of you who are here for the first time, welcome. It's that time of the year that you either love or you hate. It is pumpkin spice time. And so today, to kick off that pumpkin spice time, I am going to show you how to make incredibly easy pumpkin spice caramel cream keto cookies. And if you want a printable version of this, you can check out my website at janetsdeliciouslowcarbkitchen.com. You can find a printable version of this recipe and other goodies there for you. And if you're new to the channel and you want to see lots of easy, delicious keto recipes, make sure you click that subscribe button and click the notification bell that's right next to the subscribe button. That way you can be notified every time I put out videos every Wednesday and Saturday. And if you'd like to help support the channel, make sure you scroll down in the description of the video. You'll see some affiliate links. Anytime you purchase anything using those affiliate links, a small portion of your purchase will go to me and help support the channel. So while you do all that, let's get cooking. Preheat your oven to 375 degrees. Line two large baking sheets with parchment paper and set them aside. In a large mixing bowl, combine 57 grams or around a half cup of coconut flour, 56 grams or around 1/3 cup of golden monk fruit sweetener or brown sugar sweetener of your choice. You can adjust the sweetener more or less depending on how sweet you want your cookies. 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of dry pumpkin spice seasonings. I use my own. I just put in 1/2 teaspoon of ground cinnamon, 1/4 teaspoon of ground ginger, and 1/4 teaspoon of ground nutmeg. But if you prefer to use the pumpkin pie spice seasoning, you can use that. You can also adjust the seasonings more or less depending on how much of a spice you want to your cookies. Sift or whisk all the dry ingredients together until they're fully combined and there are no lumps in the dry ingredients. Add 3 large room temperature eggs. Make sure they are room temperature so they mix together more smooth. Stir the eggs into the dry ingredients until everything is fully combined and all the dry ingredients have been moistened by the eggs. Add 1/2 cup of room temperature butter that's been slightly softened. Make sure it's just softened, not fully melted. And 1/2 teaspoon of maple extract. You can also use vanilla extract if you prefer vanilla over maple. Stir the butter and the extract together until everything is fully combined and you have a smooth dough. Add 1/2 cup of pumpkin puree. Make sure it is just pure pureed pumpkin, not the pumpkin pie mix. The pumpkin pie mix has added sugars and added spices. You just want pure pumpkin pureed. Fold the pumpkin in until everything is fully combined and you have a smooth, moist dough. Scoop the dough out 1 tablespoon at a time and place it onto your prepared baking sheets. Keep the scoops about 1 to 2 inches apart so they have even airflow to cook evenly. Shape each one of the scoops into a ball. Then gently flatten the top of each one of the dough balls and press it down into your desired shape and thickness. This is a gluten-free dough, so it's not really going to rise or spread. Pretty much whatever shape and thickness you press it out to on the baking sheet, that's pretty much what it's going to be when you take it out of the oven once it's baked. Once the cookies are all shaped, place them in your preheated oven and bake at 375 degrees for about 10 minutes or until they're lightly golden around the edges. Once the cookies are done baking, remove them from the oven. They still will be very soft, but they will firm up a little bit as they cool. So allow them to cool in the pan for at least 10 minutes or until they're firm enough to remove from the cookie sheet without falling apart. Once the cookies have firmed up, transfer them to a wire rack and allow them to cool completely before filling the cookies. Now, these are a very soft cookie, so if you are wanting them to be a little bit more on the crisper side, you can bake them for around 12 minutes or so. Just be careful because the bottoms can burn. Or you can use a little bit less butter and pumpkin, and that'll give you a little bit more of a firm cookie. For the filling, in a medium mixing bowl, place 2 ounces of soft cream cheese. Make sure it is soft. otherwise it will not beat properly. Beat on medium for about 1 minute or until the cream cheese is smooth. Add 1 teaspoon of coconut flour and 1/2 teaspoon of maple or vanilla extract. Beat on medium for around 20-30 seconds just until the coconut flour and the vanilla are fully combined with the cream cheese. Gradually add 8 tablespoons of the powdered sweetener of your choice. I'm using powdered monk fruit allulose blend. You can use whatever powdered sweetener you want. Make sure you gradually add it in and beat on low after each addition until the powdered sweetener has been completely added and is fully combined. Once the sweetener is fully added, increase your speed to medium and beat on medium for around 2 minutes or so, or just until the filling is creamy. Add 1 tablespoon of keto caramel sauce. I'll leave a link in the description to my keto caramel sauce, or you can just buy a pre-made keto caramel sauce. You can also use more or less of the caramel sauce depending on how much of a caramel taste you want in your filling. Fold the caramel sauce in until everything is fully combined and you have a smooth filling. If the filling's a little bit too thick for you, you can always add a tiny bit of milk until it's your desired consistency. Just make sure that you don't thin it out too much. You don't want it sliding out of the cookies. You want it to keep its shape when you seal the cookies together. To assemble the cookies, turn 1/2 of the cooled cookies upside down. Make sure they are completely cooled. Then scoop about 1 teaspoon or so of the filling in the center of the upside down cookies. You can use more or less of the filling depending on how much filling you want in your cookies. Then top the filling on each cookie with a plain cookie and very gently press the cookies together until the cream is almost coming out the sides of the cookies. You should be able to see the cream, but it should not be overflowing the sides of the cookies. Once the cookies are all sealed, if you want to, you can decorate the top with a little bit of leftover caramel sauce. Then place the cookies in the refrigerator for about 10 minutes, just enough so that the cookies can seal together well. After 10 minutes, remove them from the refrigerator. You can serve them immediately. If you do have any leftovers, store them in an airtight container in your refrigerator for up to 1 week. Eat and enjoy. And that's our recipe of the day. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did and you want to see more videos like this, make sure you click that thumbs up like button, click that subscribe button, leave me a comment if you want to. Let me know if there's any recipes that you'd like to learn how to make, and I'll do what I can to get those out there for you. And as always, keep cooking.